Hey everyone, welcome to another training video. This week we're going the total opposite direction of last week. Last week was all about running slow and easy and just nice and long sustained efforts. This week is about going to the track and running as fast as possible. That's right, we are talking about track workouts and why they're probably the one thing that you're not doing that you really should be doing. Track workouts are a fantastic way to get a lot faster as a runner. There's a really great saying, I don't know who said it, it's kind of just this thing that exists in the running community, but it goes something like, in order to run faster, you have to run faster. And the idea is, if you have some expectation of PR over really any distance, you're eventually gonna have to run that pace that you've never run before. So let's say your goal is to run a six minute pace for a 5K, and currently your best is a 6:30. Well, at some point you're gonna have to do 3.1 miles at that 6 minute pace. You're gonna have to run faster than you've ever run before. So doing track workouts is a great way to practice and prep the body for these higher level efforts. Now, even if you're not somebody who's trying to go out and create some amazing PR, or you don't hope to run a 5K at, you know, 6 minute pace, or even if you're just somebody who wants to participate in the sport of triathlon, still going to the track can be incredibly helpful. And it makes a lot of sense for sprint and Olympic triathlons where you're doing a 5K or 10K and you're running pretty hard and pretty fast. So that makes sense, but it actually also applies to anybody who's doing half Ironman or even full Ironman. And that's because of the way our bodies perceive effort and the way that we train and how our bodies adapt to that training. Let me explain. So if you think of your fitness as a scale, and generally we set training zones, training intensities based off of the very top end. That's why when you do an FTP test on the bike, you have to go as hard as possible. When you set your run paces, usually it's based off of a 5K, which is as hard and as fast as you can possibly go. We set things based off of max heart rate. So we're setting things based off of our body's upper limit, not the lower limit. We only care about how hard can you possibly go. What's your max fitness level? So if you think of your fitness as a scale based on that upper limit, then training that upper limit will naturally move it higher. You will get more efficient, you'll be able to run faster, or, you know, in any case, whatever you're doing, swimming, biking, running, it'll all get faster. Well, that doesn't keep the bottom end stagnant. That, as the top moves up, the bottom moves up as well. So if you're going to the track and you're running 5 minute mile pace for a 200 and you do that maybe 8 times, that type of workout shifts the top end up and it also pulls the bottom end up along with it. So all of a sudden, those long, easy runs that we talked about last week are now just a little bit faster. So everything moves up when you work on that top end. That's the case for going to the track and doing track workouts, is you need to work on that top end because that top end pulls the bottom end up with it. So if you go to the track, 200s, 400s, 800s, even up to a 1K on the track, that's a great way to work on your marathon ability because you're training that top end, so your body gets more efficient, everything gets stronger, everything gets more equipped to handle high intensity running. Then you drop back down to your lower end, your marathon, your half marathon, and all of a sudden that is much better as well. So that's today's tip, and it goes hand in hand with last week, even though it might seem like polar opposites. Combine those long runs with those track workouts, you're working both ends of the system, and together they move your fitness forward. So I hope that helps, and we'll see you next week. Bye.